Ja, und somit herzlich willkommen zurück zu einem weiteren Reaction-Video hier zu Assassin's Creed Shadows. Denn es gibt noch ein zweites Video beim Ubisoft YouTube-Channel. Who are Nao and Yasuke? Also wer sind die beiden Charaktere eigentlich, die man im Trailer gesehen hat? Und ich bin mal gespannt darauf, vielleicht wird hier schon offengelegt, ob man irgendwie beide spielen kann oder einfach eine Sicht sieht. Das ist noch nicht ganz so klar vom Trailer her. Von daher würde ich sagen, gehen wir da direkt hinein. Let's go.
With our dual protagonists, we have two fantasies, the samurai and the shinobi. We want the player to experience both, and we cannot squeeze both fantasies into one character because the samurai and shinobi came from a different social class. They have different lives, so we cannot really mix them together.
The historical character of Yasuke presented a really exciting opportunity for the narrative team. We approached it in the same way that so much of the work is done in Assassin's Creed, which is...
Let's go.
With our dual protagonists, we have two fantasies, the samurai and the shinobi. We want the player to experience both, and we cannot squeeze both fantasies into one character because the samurai and shinobi came from a different social class. They have different lives, so we cannot really mix them together.
The historical character of Yasuke presented a really exciting opportunity for the narrative team. We approached it in the same way that so much of the work is done in Assassin's Creed, which is really in terms of research and history first. Not a lot is known about him, but what we did know, or we do know, is that he arrived in Japan in 1579, right when our game starts. And that he had relationships with some of the most interesting people in our setting, like Oda Nobunaga, the Portuguese, and Jesuits, which made it very sort of tantalizing and enticing from a narrative perspective to come in and start weaving these facts with story in between.
The more we read about the character, the more he was inspiring for us. He's a foreigner discovering Japan, and we thought it's the perfect.
Das sieht so schön aus hier. Wirklich so schön sieht das hier aus.
Fit, because he's discovering Japan and you are discovering Japan also.
And on the flip side, we have Naoe, who comes from the province of Iga, which is a remote mountainous area, fiercely independent, known as the birthplace of shinobi. So they're very contrasting perspectives that really expose a lot of different sides and facets of the era.
When Oda came, he completely destroyed Iga. You have Yasuke and Oda that coming to destroy the shinobi. So it can kind of create this interesting tension between two characters.
We were able to connect her to the province of Iga and the legendary Igan shinobi historical figure, Fujibayashi Nagato, who's her father in the game. So we understand why she has the skills that she has and the values that she learns from her father and the people of Iga, which are valor, benevolence, and wisdom. And as a young person still at the start of the game, we get to see now we acquire even more of that wisdom as the story unfolds.
And if you ask anybody, it's super clear that samurai will be combat heavy and a shinobi will be stealth heavy. It creates this distinction right away. Yasuke can fight with all his advantage, his stature, like he's a big guy. He can break door, he can fight multiple enemies, he can break armor. Compared to Naoe, like her character and their outfit, it's really about being stealth, being unseen. She's the only one with the Ebon Blade, so they have clear advantage that put them into the stealth and the combat, even if they can do a bit of both.
They're a really great pair together because on one side we have Naoe, who's very intense and passionate and determined woman who is very set on her goals. She's kind of got her heart on her sleeve and she'll say what she feels in the heat of the moment. And this intensity that she brings as a shinobi, but that she also brings to her relationship. And this balances very well with Yasuke, who is sort of a thoughtful level head to Naoe's fiery passion. we really thought about somebody like Yasuke, historically, who was able to come to Japan and have the life that he did there, to enter service for Oda Nobunaga and achieve all of the things that he did. Like, what kind of person would go through all of this? So our Yasuke is very intelligent, thoughtful, and respectful of this culture that he encounters. And that makes him a very nice sort of counterpart to Naoe. He's a bit mysterious as well, and that's something we get to see unfold as the game progresses.
Assassin's Creed Shadows. Also, so viel klarer ist das jetzt für mich auch nicht. Vielleicht ist es auch schon klar, vielleicht weiß man das schon länger, dass man irgendwie beide spielen kann oder bloß einen von beiden auswählen kann. Wenn das auf jeden Fall so ist, dann werde ich sicherlich, glaube ich, eher mit Naoe spielen, also die Stealth-Charakterin hier. Weil mir das ein bisschen besser gefällt bei Assassin's Creed. Und es ist ein interessantes Duo, weil sich beide so ein bisschen ergänzen. Der Samurai eher so tough, hart in der Front und Naoe mit der Shinobi. Heißen die, glaube ich, wenn ich es richtig gehört habe, eher so im Stealth-Modus, schleichend, leise. Ist ein cooles Duo, finde ich nice. Und vielleicht müsste ich mich dann noch ein bisschen mehr recherchieren oder durchlesen, ob man das schon weiß, wie genau das gemeint ist, ob man die Geschichte einfach auf wie einer Seite von den beiden erleben kann. Auf jeden Fall ziemlich nice. Ich bin gespannt. Ich werde das Spiel spielen. Wie gesagt, ich finde es nice. Das Setting wirklich sehr cool. Interessiert mich auch ehrlich gesagt ein bisschen mehr als jetzt Mirage. Auch wenn Mirage ziemlich cool aussah in den Trailern. Und ja, vielen Dank fürs Zuschauen hier bei diesem React. Wir sehen uns beim nächsten Mal wieder. Haut rein. Tschüss.